Recently, in my own organization, I received a very interesting email from a business that my firm has done business with. The content of the message was supposedly an electronic fax message. Now, typically, I don't get electronic faxes being sent to my inbox, so I knew at first it was suspect. What was interesting to me was when I attempted to respond back to the person and say, "Hey, I think you've got a problem with your email." The response email I got was clearly a script that was running on the machine. The response I got back was an automatic email that basically was urging me to go ahead and click on the link because, of course, it was a legit email. So clearly, the attackers had taken over the mailbox, and then they'd also written email rules inside the mailbox so that should anyone respond back, that they would get an automatic email back, like I got, saying, "Oh, go ahead, click on that link. It's perfectly fine." Now, I find it interesting that not only did the original email get through my mail filters, but this follow-up one also got through my mail filters as well. Recently, the FBI Cyber Division released a document warning about business email compromise. Specifically, they alerted to ensure that we reviewed for forwarding rules. As they stated, more than $1.7 billion in worldwide losses were reported to the Internet Crime Center in 2019. So in their document, they recommended several settings in there that you went through to make sure your system was set up properly. So down here are the recommendations. They wanted to make sure that both the desktop and the web applications were running the same version to allow syncing. Now, in the case of the examples provided by the FBI, the lack of synchronization meant that the web clients, the attackers went after the web clients and put rules in place, but the desktop did not show these rules. Next, they wanted you to be wary of last-minute changes in established email account addresses. Now, in my situation, while I recognized the email address, the firm that I was working with was moving to a brand new mail system and to a brand new mail domain, so clearly there was changes going on. You want to make sure that when you work with vendors that suddenly they don't say, "Hey, I want you to send it instead to this Gmail account." Next, you want to carefully check email addresses for slight changes that can make fraudulent addresses appear legit. For example, if you use fonts, it's very easy to make the letter L look like a number 1. So carefully look for that wording changes. You want to enable multi-factor authentication for all email accounts. I cannot stress this enough, that multi-factor goes a huge way to making sure your systems are secure. If you have not taken upon yourself to do that, make sure it's a project for the 2021 year. Absolutely make sure you have multi-factor on all email accounts. Next, you want to prohibit automatic forwarding of email to external addresses. Now, Microsoft 365 is in the process of making this default. You want to check your settings and make sure they're already doing this. You want to make sure you proactively do that. You want to monitor the email exchange server for changes in configuration and make sure custom rules for specific accounts are set and not changed. Change management is so key. Next, you want to create a rule to flag email communications where the reply email address differs from the from. You can also set up DKIM to reject mail that doesn't match the domain of the originating mail server. Next, you can add an email banner to messages coming from outside your organization. This is a pretty common step for people to do, to alert people that the email originates outside of the organization. But keep in mind that you may still need end-user education to make users aware of how the emails will look. I've actually seen attacker emails have that same similar banner, but the good news is usually it's in a different format than what your firm has. So you want to make sure that you have a very unique style of external banner and have it such that your employees know what is your way of doing it and how others may do it. Next, you want to consider the legacy email protocols such as POP, IMAP, and SMTP. Keep in mind that old protocols can be easily attacked and hacked. In addition, too many of us reuse credentials on various platforms, so it's very easy for an attacker to find a database of stolen credentials and attempt to log into your system with these reused credentials. So again, you want to look at your legacy email protocols and turn them off. You want to ensure that changes to mailbox login and settings are retained at least for 90 days. Now, if you don't have that as default, you may have to use some sort of third-party platform in order to save the logging. There's platforms such as Microsoft Sentinel as well as Splunk that can be used to perform additional logging on your environment. Next, you want to enable security features that block malicious emails, such as anti-phishing and anti-spoofing policies. Too often we purchase security services and we don't fully set them up. If you have Microsoft 365 or Office 365, I highly recommend you check out the IT Pro Mentor website for their best practices list for setting up Exchange Online. He's got lots of tips and tricks for setting those settings inside the Exchange to ensure it's as secure as it can be. Next, the FBI recommends that you clarify any suspicious payment requests, especially when you're working with any sorts of large dollar volumes. It's okay to slow down the process and tell the person, go ahead and call, or confirm some other way other than just plain old email. Take the time to slow down the process and double check. I also highly recommend that, again, if you have Office 365 or Microsoft 365, that you look to see what alert policies you can set up. There's lots and lots of settings you can do to alert you to suspicious activities. It'll give you, now depending on your subscription, you may need to have an E1 or E3 or E5, but you want to look to see what these alerts do, especially for data loss prevention, threat management. They'll let you know when somebody clicks a malicious URL, triggers an investigation of email, creating a forwarding or redirect rule. Again, this is really, really important with a business email compromise. You want to make sure that you have any kind of alerts on that. And in general, just take a look at these threat management ones and see if there's any that you want to set up as alerts. Finally, take the time to notify authorities that you've had a business email compromise. You may think to yourself that, gee, it's not much, I can't get a lot of dollar amount, but the important thing is that the authorities know and can track the patterns. Even if you aren't specifically helped in this situation where you don't get your money back, often the authorities can see patterns. They can get see where what attackers are doing and kind of the overall threat environment of everyone out there. So by all means, check with your Federal Bureau of Investigation Internet Crime Complaint Center. If you have cyber insurance, make sure you notify them. If you have any other organization, especially for those of you overseas, Australia has a very good cyber organization. So again, look to see if your local organizations have any notification process and use that. And as always, make sure you sign up for the videos out of the IGDG Tech Top YouTube channel. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Make sure you stay safe and stay secure.